Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, you will learn sending email with PHP. This is next point of handling email with PHP. How to send email? We know that we are using the mail function, okay? Mail function to send email in PHP, okay? Here we are sending the simple email. Okay, to send email using PHP, you must configure the php.ini file. Then what is mean by php.ini file? Actually, it is the default configuration file. We are using default configuration file for running application that requires PHP. Okay, those application we need to configure this file and run this application. Actually, it is used to control variables such as upload sizes, file timeout and resources limit, etc. And we need all these things when we are sending the email. So to send the email using the PHP, you must configure the php.ini file with the details of how your system sends email. Open the file php.ini and go to the section entitled mail function and set your SMTP setting. You need to do these settings. So set your SMTP setting as SMTP equals to smtp.my.server.net. You need to write this. Then set your send mail from setting to reflect your email address. So you need to write send mail from. So you need to write your email address. See, here is one simple example in that PHP. The message is first line of text, then slash n means on the next line you want second line of text. Here we are using the one function word wrap. Word wrap for what? If your line or if your string, your message is longer than 70 character, it automatically wraps to the next line. So here we are using the dollar message equals to word wrap in bracket dollar message comma 70. Okay, so and after that we are using the mail function. Okay, so mail function, here we are using the email address, then my subject and the message, the body. Okay, so let's see in mail function which are the different components. See, here is a different components of the mail function. So first one is parameter and second is description of this function. We are using the mail function to send an email, and here is a different parameter. The function requires three mandatory arguments that specify the recipient email address, the subject of the message and the actual message. Okay, this parameter is mandatory? Requires the three mandatory arguments that specify the recipient's email address, the subject of the message and the actual message. Additionally, there are other two optional parameters also there. So what is the syntax of this? Syntax is boolean. The data type is boolean mail, then string $2. See, here I have written mail to subject, message, header and parameter, but for each and every component having a specific data type. So boolean mail in bracket string $2 comma string $subject, then string $message. Okay, these three are the mandatory, and then headers and parameters are the optional field. So you can write the string $additional headers, then string $additional parameters. Okay, headers and parameters are the optional. To subject message are the compulsory parameter, compulsory component of this mail message. So two required specifies the receiver or receivers of the email. Okay, single or multiple receivers will be there. Subject required, it is also the required, specify the subject of the email. This parameter cannot contain any new line character. Okay, this cannot contain the any new line character. Then next is message. You can write the message here more than 70 character also. So you need a new line character here. This is a compulsory field. It defines the message to be sent. Each line should be separated with a line field, that is slash n. Line should not exceed the 70 characters. The next field is header. Header is an optional field. It specifies the additional header like a CC and BCC. As per your requirement, you can add the CC and the BCC. Next is parameter. This is also the optional field. It is an optional, specifies an additional parameter that can be used to pass additional flags as a command line option to the program configured to be used when sending mail as defined by the send mail path configuration setting. See, this is parameter is optional. Okay. So, which of these are the mandatory? Two subject message, headers and parameters are the mandatory, not mandatory field. These are the optional field. These are the component. And here is one example, send an HTML email. How to send an HTML email? Okay, when you send a text message using PHP, then all the content will be treated as a simple text. See, when you are sending the text message using the PHP, all the contents will be considered as a simple text. Even if you will include the HTML tags in a text, it will be displayed as simple text and HTML tags will not be formatted according to HTML syntax. If you are using the HTML in that also, then also there is a problem. But PHP provides the option to send an HTML message as an actual HTML message. But by using the PHP, you can provide this, you can send this. While sending an email message, you can specify the MIME version, content type and character set to send an HTML email. Okay, here is one example. We'll send an HTML email message to some address. Copying it to the some address, you can code this program in a such way that it should receive all the content from the user and then it should send an email. So let's see the program. Here is a two. So here you have written the two, then the somebody else example .com, then subject. Here is a subject is HTML email. So here dollar message, inside the message you are writing all these things and see carefully, see here from the dollar message, this HTML, this line HTML line to HTML line, see this is HTML code to see, and the at the right hand side there is a at the fifth line double quote completion and semicolon. So here is your HTML message, here is your mail message body part. Okay, so under the dollar message equals to double quote, you have written all this information, means HTML email, this email contains HTML tags and first name, last name and all the information inside the table. So here is the end of this. So after this, right, always set the content type when sending HTML email. So you need to set the content type. So header equals to MIME version 1.0, you need to set the headers also. So content type. So while sending an email message, you can specify the MIME version and content type and character set. So you need to write these three. Okay, and three, and then more headers. How to include the more headers? It's also like a from, CC. If you want to add this from or CC, you can write it. And then send this data using the mail function, that is a CM. Last is, here is mail function. So by using the mail to subject message and comma dollar headers, you can send the message. See, in this you have written like this. First is you have started with the PHP, then in that two subject is there, then message. Inside the message there is a HTML tag because we are sending an HTML email. Okay, so after this here is a content type and MIME version, and then use of mail function to send the mail. Now next is sending attachment with email. How to send attachment with email? To send the email with mixed content requires to set a content type. You need a content type. Okay, header to multipart or mixed. If you are trying to send, then you need to set a content type, header to multipart, mixed. Then text and attachment section can be specified within boundaries. You need to mention these also. And here you can use the one function MD5. Okay, for the encryption, you can use this function. And when you are sending the message, see, boundary separate the multiple part of the message. It begins with the two hyphens. You need to add the two hyphens followed by a unique number which cannot appear in the message part of the email. Then a PHP function MD5. You are using this function. A PHP function MD5 is used to create a 32-digit hexadecimal number. We are using the MD5 function to create a 32-digit hexadecimal number to create unique number. So by using this function, you can create a unique number. A final boundary denoting the email's final section must also end with the two hyphen. Again, we are using the two hyphen. And attach file should be encoded with the base64 encode function. Here you can use the base64 encode function for safer transmission and are best split into chunks with the chunk split function. Here we are using the two more functions when you are attaching the any file or when there is an attachment with your email. Base64 encode function for safer transmission and check split function to is used for best split into chunks with the chunk split function. Okay, and by using this you can send the emails easily with the attachment. Thank you.